Okay, Terry, sorry about the mess, but I'm not going to pretend that we're all clean and pristine all the time because we're not. In this cupboard, in the corner cupboard here, you will find toweling paper, a bucket full of lots of animal stuff. I haven't still got a few bird things to put in there. This bucket here is the one that I do the cleaning with, you know, when I have to go around with some wet water and dust and pick up bird pollen and stuff like that. And we always use the blue cloth, which there's one in here with the bird food already. Okay, the best way to remember this is that blue is for poo, so never use this on good dishes. This is what we use to wipe up Swiss poo off of the counter, which there isn't any this morning because she hasn't been in. That toaster there belongs in there, though what you do with it while you're here, we don't really care because we're not going to be here to see it. So what I was getting out of here is this jug. Normally I make up the bird food with this jug and that container, except for when we have lots of birds around. At the moment we do, and I'm going to use this container here. I only use it when I need to, just because it takes up fridge space, and well, we have to fit beers and ciders in that fridge, you know, and a few veggies. And the lid is here. I've worked out after doing some maths that it's best to do 1 cup of bird food to not quite 2 litres of water. So I'm thinking about 1 litre and 800 mils makes the best thickness, and then add whatever fruit that you've got. So we don't always add fruit. If we're in a hurry, we don't add fruit. If we've got lots of fruit, like at the moment, this is where we keep the fruit over here. Yes, it's very messy. It's because that's because I decided to tidy out my toolbox, and so everything's pushed to the side because I've got some rust in it. So if you need anything, that's the toolbox, which is usually kept under the chair here in the front passage. That backpack won't be there because it's coming with us. Oh, in case I forget to say it at any other stage, there is a heap of raincoats that I'll be leaving behind, scarf, some more raincoats, hat. This basket here is full of all dog bits. This is what I call the dog bag. And in here you will find balls, which you only need if you've got Harry next door. Earphones, in case you want to listen to your phone. I usually put my phone in here too. And I'm not sure that I'll leave the sunnies. Dog bags, there should be a heap in here, but I'll top them up to make sure. Oh, and these new pair of pyjamas for Snoopy at night time, in case he's getting cold. Okay, they look very, very cute on him. That's where I put the dog food. I wash the dog food container every day and change his water. I'll show you later how to get him to have a good drink of water. Okay, so here we are. This is the pantry cupboard. I'm going to put it that way so you can see. So up there on the right is all the different drinks that you might like. Down here is a heap of vitamin tablets, the breadboards, mint tea. And in this cupboard here, as you can see, are the aprons. In this box here, we keep the plastic bags, and we keep, well, I don't know why the popcorn's in there, but we usually keep in there potatoes, sweet potatoes, and onion, if sweet potato and onion aren't put in the fridge. There's a thermos there, in case you want to take a thermos out with you. Keeps very hot. It looks a bit dodgy, but it keeps very hot. Oh, this is a mouse trap. It's electronic. There's no mouse in it at the moment, but if you see, let me find it here. Okay, turn it off, open it up. Sorry, it requires two hands. lift the lid off, open it up, put the cheese or peanut butter on that end, put the lid down, turn the switch on. You can see it's flashing, it's electronic. It will kill the mice in a split second, which is really, really good. So it's not being cruel to them. Yes, we're killing them, but we're not being cruel to them. They're dying immediately. We also have poison around, but I hate using it. It's just that sometimes, because we've got a paddock across the road and birds in the house, we get an abundance of mice. Help yourself to anything in here. And I think that's mint tea by the looks of it. There's a whole lot of different herb teas up here. Chamomile tea there. That's scales in case you cook. Turmeric. This container here is full of just about every spice or herb you could think of. Coconut oil and Himalayan salt. On that side I keep spreads. Baking things are at the top. And also, there should be a plastic container here with baking flour in it. Yeah, that's on that side. That's all natural flours. What I mean is gluten-free. Lots and lots of gluten-free flour. A mandolin in case you're going to go crazy with your cooking. And what I'm after right now is in this container here, which I keep Lorikeet food and dog biscuits. Bought dog biscuits, not homemade ones. Just trying to get the best picture for you. Because we have had not only mice but pantry moths, we need to keep everything in cupboards. And that's why I keep so much stuff in the fridge. In the bottom, we've got two vegetable drawers, but one of them we keep for flowers. So here, that's the Lorikeet bird food. And I'm going to put in one cup out of the jug, this jug. Sorry, I'm not hands-free. I don't have Kevin holding it for me today. I'm going to put this down while I put the Lorikeet mix in. Hopefully you can see something. And you don't have to be exact. Oops, which I'm just not being. One cup. Oh, now I've got doubting myself. Hang on a minute, I'll check my notes. Yep, one cup of Lorikeet mix. Two litres of boiling water minus a couple of hundred. So I am going to go one, two, and that little stir. Looking a bit thin, so I might only go 2.5 litres and see how that works out before we go overboard. For some reason each day is different, so it's not like a recipe that you have to follow. Now, so you see there, there, I don't know why it's all gone a bit fuzzy.